Welcome to Illusion Fox Gaming. So today we're doing the level 25 Rogue Quest Sweet Sorrows. Jack wishes to discuss the plan for recovering the remaining treasures. Oh there, we've a rough job ahead of us, and that's a fact. Matters are tangled enough what with the Malala more snapping our heels, but we still managed to gravel that first shrink without too much fuss. Biting back them other two treasures, that'll be a different story. Once the stray gets here, I'll explain what or more to the point who we're up against. Alright, we've two bulbs left on the list, the Silver Sorrows and the Black Sarcophagus. Let's see where we're at. Alright, where's Paramu got to? Underfoot, he's still looking to whittle the tail behind that bleeding sarcophagus. We'll not be cloying that sickler until we've at least an inkling as to what the bloody thing looks like. Treasure aside, I've been doing some digging on my own into these executioner allies, the Grin and Curse, and I'm afraid the name weren't no coincidence. You've heard of the bloody executioners, I hope. It seems them Curse was feeding from the fanvil of one of them nation's greatest pirate powers. This ain't no ordinary crew of cutthroats, lass. Within Limsa Lamensa, the bloody executioners yield a power and influence second only to the Admiral herself. They was none too fond of Merwebin or her prohibition on piracy, and it was under only the overwhelming threat posed by the Garlean Empire would eventually convince them to play nice with that, the Thalassocracy. But pirates ain't one to play nice for long. Now that Hilfiger amped around to helm the ship, the solidarity of the bloody executioners has begun to show cracks. All the strongest captains and lieutenants have begun to form their own factions, and are scrabbling to claim the top chair for themselves. Of course, not one bloody cove can agree with another on which the way the executioners ought to sail. Among these new factions, though, is a group that is pushing to break free of the Admiral's grip completely. Turns out these reformists, as they call themselves, was the one as took the Grin and Curse under their wing. Which means they've got possession of the last few treasures we've yet to cloy. Rumors around town say that even the executioners, these coves are bloody and ruthless and not to be crossed. We should set this one out, Jack. Piss on Malala's contest, it ain't worth this kind of grief. We'd be inviting the wrath of a crew so large and dangerous that even the Admiral ain't keen on coming to blows with them. If they ever came after us. Large or small, it don't much matter. They broke the code when they hit the maelstrom tub. Aye, the Grin and Curse are paying for their crime. But we'd be poor grin and sodden excuses for rogues if we let the real culprits carry on unpunished. I mean to see this job to the end, and that means biting back them treasures and handing out proper justice to them as deserving. But Jack, listen, with all the infighting going on at present, us stabbing a sharp blade into one faction's toes ain't like to bring the whole executioner crew down on our heads. Besides, them reformist buggers are so far split from the main mob, they've been avoiding the city altogether. Now, it's about time we got to work. You're to track down our black market contact. I set him to looking into the Curse's new allies a while back, so he should have an answer for us by now. The veil was lifted by Southerly this morning, though. That'll put the old man at his haunt in Lower Lanossia. Here, take this sack of blunt and pay a visit to the House of Sticks. That's kobold territory, if you didn't know. The old man bribes them with ore and hires the biggest and meanest sods as bodyguards. Just be ready for your approach to be challenged. Again? Really? Really? Okay. We'll go and take care of it. Not like I have anything better to do. I really don't, but considering the time I'm actually trying to film this, or record this, I should actually be getting ready to stream, but... I'm basically filming this last minute before going on a trip. And so, because I don't know how much availability I'll have to actually record anything or stream any while I am away. So, trying to get as much of it done as I can beforehand. We gotta save the Black Marketeer. Among the House of Sticks, young rogue. You must excuse my hireling's enthusiasm for greeting visitors. Now, have you any cumbersome baggage of which I might relieve you before we begin our conversation in earnest? A heavy burden for one of your tender years to bear, but its weight has balanced the scales. The sum is paid and the deal is made. Let us speak of these reformists. This faction that so wronged the code now seeks to peddle one of its stolen treasures. The earrings, better known as the Silver Sorrows. The deal, it is said, is set to take place at Costa del Sol. The buyer, a mining merchant from the golden sands of Ulda. The earrings will be out in the open, vulnerable. I would target the moment of transaction were I so inclined. As the gentleman up there by the cabin appears to be, for he purchased this self-same information. Though he attempts to disguise his identity, the stench of a soldier yet lingers. I know not where one such as he came to learn of my existence, but I suspect he works for a certain yellow-coated captain. Brave she is, but foolish. Stumble blindly into the underworld, and your groping hands will not save you from the holes at your feet. Sudden shall be her fall. Seriously, just told us to go to Costa del Sol, and we're going back to the Rogue's Guild. That seems counter to what I feel like we should be going and doing. But what the fuck do I know? Nothing. Potatoes and rocks know more than I do. Welcome back. What information did the old man have on them, reformists? Looking to unload them earrings, are they? And to an old one, no less. Can't say as I'm surprised to hear the buyers from out of town. You won't find many Lamensons willing to melt coin and not them coves are selling. Only the daftest sods would go about finding fund them as means to pull down the admiral. Hey, one of Malala's lackeys were at the house before ye? How did they know to... Bah, them curs we captured must have cackled during the shrew's interrogations. We'll have to assume the Yellowjacks know what we know, and that means we best get our asses Costa del Sol right bleeding now. I'll handle this one, Jack. You and Illusion can wait here for Pyramu. Aye, waiting the hells is she playing at after her last. She knows that this ain't a solo job. I told you to wait at the guild. I don't need... Well, might as be as I could use an extra mort in the shadows after all. Jack has mind set on punishing the executioners, but me? I just want to skulk and cloy them silver bits and skulk out. I reckon that if I could manage that with no one in the wiser, then they wouldn't know you who'd came to come after. Finish the job without drawing me daggers, you know? Not exactly true to the code, but the shield of underworld honor won't stop them bloody killers from cutting me mates' throats and setting the sisters a glimmer. The guild's the only place that would offer to take in a pirate stray like me, and I'll not see it burn to the ground. Guild's about to start. Say when you're bene to head in. Alright, here's what we know. The rich merchant was come over from Ulda's some old mate, Master Gijiruju. The calls that owns Costa del Sol. Taking his guards and dancing dells and pranced off down the beach someplace, giving over the use of the entire resort to his friend. Seems she didn't want an audience for her bargains with reformants. Which, as it happens, works out well for us. We'll wait until they're busy haggling over price and snatch at sorrows and hope the twig before they realize the odds are missed. Sounds like a plan? Sure, why not? We'll go with it. There, the players have arrived. The Reformer's coin counter and the Olden buyers are setting up on the southeast platform. The earrings ought to be nearby. Hang about, who are all these other culls? The place was meant to be empty. I see some nasty looking blokes in Olden garb. And are those mammoths? That merchant's brought along a whole bloody entourage. I've gone ahead of myself. I should have realized the job would never be that easy. We'll have to mill a few of them bodyguards first, I reckon. You don't want to fight through a force of blades should we get caught sneaking that up, about up on them narrow walkways. Jack, So, still your excuses, love. I know full well what you're about. You start going soft on us, though, and it'll be like losing one of me arms. I can't take on the bloody executioners all by myself. It's only because I've got rogues like you and Underfoot and Illusion here that the guild can take the jobs it does. When our coves walk the shadows, it's the bleeding pirates what do the trembling. Remember that, Vakebe. We ain't some two guild robbers what piss their breeches when their daddies are caught in the honeypot. We're the knives and the darkmans, and no bastard wants to go blade to blade with the likes of us. You see, you've not changed your mind then. We'll need all the stabbers we can get, and I promise mine will be there when you need them. Bene, now let's carve a path to that platform and bite back them earrings. Vakebe, you hide yourself down by the docks in case the marks escape during the fighting. You and me will split up and mill the guards as we go. Some puppets is concerning me most. I suggest we crash some little buggers before they can spring any rum fun. Creep in as close as you dare, then give him a good, solid clout from behind. I ain't the most original strategy, but that don't make it any less lethal. Once you're done with the first group, slip back in the shadows and move to the next. Not to it, eh? I'll head over to the back while you stay starting from the front. Let's wrap this up before them jacks blunder in and scare off our marks. I was like, what do I still have to deal with? I was like, oh, he's too slow and hasn't gotten through his people yet. Rogues, no one mentioned an odd about rogues. What the hell do you think you're doing? I'm conducting business transaction on behalf of the Bloody Executioners. Do you understand what that means? Do you know what they'll do to you? I'm all frightened. Odd that when you're the one who's shaken. It don't much matter to me who ye work for. Your bosses broke the code and we're here to collect. Those be the Silver Sorrows, then. I'm sure you paid a caravan coin for them shiny bulbs, but I doubt they're worth your life. Let's have them, then. Wait, damn you. You should know that this personage is an extremely influential member of the East Owner Trading Company. Surely you've heard of it. Through every pause will not stay your hand, then consider the political ramifications of interfering with a foreign dignitary. The Emperor would not desire you to damage Limsa's relations with Ulda. Yes, exactly. I'm a very high place in Ulda society. I have powerful friends who would not be pleased were you to mistreat me in any fashion. You must understand the Silver Stars are a scroll treasure, a gift once bestowed upon Sultana Nanasha Ulnasha by her champion. The earrings were later stolen from the royal vault when we lost hope of ever recovering them. That I might so easily purchase them thus is a miracle. The return of these strings will be, or that is to say, the stars must return to Ulda. Can you not look the other way for the sake of my nation's pride? You must think me some dull-witted thug. If this deal were being made on behalf of your country, then why are you singing about and consorting with pirates? An excellent point. One might doubt your quality of character were you to continue with these feeble fabrications. You need only entrust those earrings to me, should you truly wish to see them return to Ulda, that is. After all, it was to fulfill that very purpose that the Thalassocracy bid on the Sorrows in the first place. Bit late here, there, aren't you, Captain? I think we'll agree this round belongs to us. No, she's not. On the contrary, my dear scoundrel. I made the winning move the moment I knew we were dealing with a merchant of Ulda. I come bearing an official order of seizure, authorized by the Admiral herself. You will not be harmed, but I must insist that you cooperate with this reclamation of unlawfully obtained goods. Though Costa del Sol is private property, it nevertheless lies within state-governed territory. Come along quietly, and we need not inconvenience Master Gigi Ruju any further. These suspects will be taken into Yellow Jacket custody, and do not concern yourself with the Silver Sorrows. They'll be quite safe with me. You little bitch. Bah, the hell's to take that canary-colored harpy. You might as well have handed the thing to her on a velvet cushion. I'll go find Underfoot and help him with his digging. There's still that last treasure out there, and you can't be sure the reformers won't be giving it up without a fight. Ah, you do that, Benny. Luck to you, love. Ah, there you are. You left before events had truly been decided, and I thought you deserved to know the score. The old merchant has acquiesced to our request and surrendered their Silver Sorrows into our keeping. We've also apprehended the reformer's accountant, and we'll be holding him for further questioning. Bonin and associate of the Bloody Executioners, you Yellow Jackets don't flinch from your duty, I'll give you that. And what's this I hear about you buying information, Captain? I thought you'd sooner die than associate with the elements of the underworld. I'll do what I must to stay ahead in this challenge, and that marketeer's knowledge is vital to the case. It's true I might find his practices distasteful, but he is no pirate. It is the fading era of piracy which I mean to consign to the history books, and that chapter will never be fully closed until every pirate-spawned relic, including you and your guild, becomes a thing of the past. Valiant and forthright, these are the words by which the Yellow Jackets live. It is the manner in which we protect Limsa Limensa. I swore an oath on the graves of my sisters, no more shall the innocent suffer at the hands of these savage buccaneers, these unrepentant killers. And a grand oath it is. Me, I've got me family's full just keeping the code intact. But the code is a kind of oath, too, when you get down to it. And since I've sworn to uphold it, I've no intention of stepping aside and letting you trample all over me or my coves. In fact, you'd better off giving in before matters get proper serious. Just say you're sorry, admit defeat, and we'll leave it at that, eh? Your audacity knows no bounds. I am done wasting words. I shall reclaim that last treasure, and then I'll look on victorious as your guild is dismantled brick by brick. That's the spirit, Captain. Just don't forget to keep an eye on them earrings. The city's crawling with rogues, you know. If we could keep the sorrows in a bloody lockbox in the Coral Tower, but look away for a moment and one of Miko's will bite them beauties right back. Come on, back to the sisters for us. Back to the Rogues Guild it is. Well, after all that hard work, the shrew made off with the spoils. As far as her damn contest goes, I suppose that doesn't mean... That makes us even. It'll be the last treasure of this black sarcophagus that decides the victor. Whatever the reformers are doing to keep it, Bob, you can bet your grandmom's teeth there'll be some blade work needed before this job is done. Get yourself ready for a proper scrap. And, well, that was the level 25 rogue quest. Sweet Sorrows. Thank you for joining us here on Illusion Fox Gaming on YouTube. Hopefully we'll see you again either for another video here on YouTube, or maybe one of our mini streams over on Twitch. Till then, I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day, though.